Still think we should have corked that hole.
We were trying. We had every. No, we just spent the last like 5 hours.
Yeah, literally, this entire session has been planning.
Yeah. It was all for naught.
Still think going in.
Well, if I am an impartial DM, then just as defeating an enemy and destroying that enemy is something worthy of XP, being responsible for the destruction of an entire town should be worth some number of XP.
Wait a minute. I just thought of something. If they are sending these masses toward the town, their home base is wide open.
Even if they send 50, that still leaves 50 at their home base.
Exactly, yeah. We can still go there, open up the mutants, and let them out. So when they come back home, yes, we're victorious!
There's more than 50 as you're running down the mountains.
We can see that there's more than 50. Mm-hmm.
There's at least 70 or 80.
Yeah, okay, so they've got most of their people coming.
Yeah, there's more like 2/3 than 1/3.
Wow, okay.
You can attack the whole base.
Yeah, that's true. We'd have much better chances.
There are only 3 of us.
But if we got the others, we'd hide and run off to the side.
It's going
to
take you another 4 hours to go back and gather the others.
I can spend my highest level spell slot to summon them here, sending. So they'll know to come. Hmm. But
wait a minute. What do you got to do? Spend the spell slot to do what?
To communicate with them.
But what about what's one the sound spoke?
Yeah. Did we decide that they're at the town?
My range is
only camping on the edge of town right now.
So then we communicate to them, warn the town, get everyone to evacuate, and then come to us. And that'll save us.
The British are coming.
Right.
One if by land, two if by sea.
Our people only have to warn
Spoiler alert!
Our people only have to warn them, because we could send the workers back to warn everybody.
No, that's the workers are not with you.
Yeah, they're back at the town.
I thought they were with the other guys.
No.
We're farther.
They're at home. They're at home in their beds. It's midnight.
Okay.
Or whatever. It's like
crack monkeys. We gotta go back to the town.
Why?
Tommy! He's in the mayor's place.
Well, wait, 3 of us.
If they burn the place down?
Half of us are in the town.
Holy crap, if they burn the mayor's house down.
Tommy will die.
Yeah, Tommy will die. Tommy will die if the mayor's house gets burned down.
Yeah, we just said, though, that half of our group is in town.
Right.
While they're spreading the word, they'll go grab Tommy.
Yeah. One of them runs.
Hopefully they'll run.
Okay, I think we have.
How many words can you send in
25 messages? Words.
25 words?
Oh, yeah, you can do it.
Okay. Yeah.
Just think carefully about what you're saying.
Exactly.
Well, this is what we want to do, though.
Warn
before I send it. Is this exactly what we want to do? Send them a message. Bring them here.
It makes the most sense to use, even though it's burning a spell slot. Send the message, get them to do all that stuff, and come back, and that saves us however many hours of travel down there to tell them that in the first place. Meanwhile, the whole army's traveling down there. We go back.
Mm-hmm.
While they're doing that, we raid their home and destroy it, and we escape before they get back.
I think it absolutely happens simultaneously.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah. As opposed to if we run all the way down there,
actually,
and then come
you
back.
Can get a head start because you've only run for like 10 minutes.
Right.
They still have 4 hours until they get to the town. You can double back and avoid them and start.
Well,
now.
The 3 of us can, but if we wanted to go in as a
right. True.
I wonder if we could somehow get in there, cause enough havoc inside their base that they'll send people to bring people back.
You mean they'll stop the raid because we're attacking?
Yeah, I think that's our only hope of saving the town.
Hmm.
Which means the 3 of us have to get in there now, while they're still close enough to the cave that they can send a messenger and gather everyone back.
Hmm. That's true. Okay. Let's do that.
So we go in there. First thing we do is start grabbing people and going, go get your people, and throw them in the hole. So they'll land and they'll go warn everybody that we're in there attacking.
So either way, I think sending them a message now is still the best plan.
Okay, yeah, so...
So, but, you have that. I didn't memorize Animal Messenger, but I did memorize or prepare Speak with Animals. One of the things you get says is, you might even persuade a beast to perform a favor for you at DM's discretion. So I could try and ask a little bird to
but
go
then it would take them however many hours to get down.
Yeah, mine's an instant communication.
Okay. Yeah, as long
25 words.
Yeah.
Warn everyone in the village. Save Tommy from certain doom. No, just save Tommy.
I'll just say...
Save Tommy at Mayor's house.
Say army of 80 coming. save Tommy, warn town. Meet us in that cave.
Yeah.
We'll be raiding. That's 15.
Yeah.
How about meet us at palace?
Meet us at palace? Okay.
Yeah,
meet us at palace. We'll be raiding.
Yeah. Hurry. A lot. Really fast. That's 19.
Yeah.
I think I can say the message that we have.
Okay.
Yeah.
So. Does it allow punctuation?
Wait! One more thing. Bring lots of oil.
Don't say that. They'll have enough.
Yeah. All right, let's do it.
Is there anything else that needs to be said?
That's a good question. I was thinking about that.
10 more words.
Saving Tommy is pretty important.
Take the mayor's gold.
Take the mayor's gold. That's only 4 hours full of so much
promise. Save Tommy. Warn the town. Evacuate the town. Yeah.
Steal mayor's gold. That's my 3 words.
Yeah, this from now on, this is Tommy.
Okay. Yeah.
Plant it from now on. Hopefully not from
now on. Yeah, for the time being.
Okay.
And this guy's in jail, right?
Mm-hmm.
He was saying that the city, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. That's gonna shine up you guys.
Might as well kill a hostage.
Yeah.
They don't want to add to their numbers anymore.
2 words for that. Yep. Kill hostage. Yeah.
We can't give them too much to do because then they'll get trapped there.
Maybe like avoid army.
Where's
the
guy whose base you took off?
Oh, he was laying on your towel right on top.
Mm-hmm. I think most of the time that they're spending is going to be yelling for people to evacuate.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
So the other results we give them shouldn't add up to too much more. Mm-hmm. They can do that on the way.
Yeah, definitely.
You want to type out the 25 words so you know exactly what you said? Because it may come into question next game session.
I already forgot exactly what it was.
Well, I can type it out.
Yeah, that's true. Well, let me put it in my DMs.
Well, let me come up with it first.
Yeah, no, that's fine. I mean, I'll rewrite it until you hit send. It's not sending.
More intense scene.
God, that was an intense idea. That's awesome. I should be a bad guy. I think I kind of am a bad guy.
That's
magic. Okay, let's go raid their place.
Yeah, you know, they say it's impossible to run through a campsite. You can only ram through a campsite because it's past tense. You can only ram through a campsite because it's past tense.
Past tense, you're right.
Oh, past tense.
I got it. I just thought it was corny.
Oh,
and what is this spell called?
Sending. So unlimited range on the same plane. 25 words, and then they can answer.
So Belden, Darius, and...
No, even on the other planes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so army of coming, evacuate town, save Tommy, kill hostage, meet us in palace.
Yep. In the sky palace. Okay,
and
what's, I'm sorry, say the name of the spell again.
Sending.
Did you put kill hostage?
Yeah.
Okay, alright, read it off to me.
Wait, did you put army of 80 yuan-ti? So they don't think they're army friendly?
Yeah.
Might as well.
If you can spare the word, I can do it. Huh?
Enemies, one word.
Yuan-ti is one. Okay, what does it say?
So far, I'm not done. So far, army of 80 yuan-ti coming. Evacuate town, save Tommy, kill hostage, meet us in palace.
Read it again.
Is that?
Yeah.
That's
fine. Like I said, like I'm not gonna.
Yeah, we can change it.
I just want to get
change
it down
it.
So that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can change. We can add to it if we need to.
Now, do we need to?
he's not making it finalized.
I just want it. Yeah, I'm not finalizing it. Like I said,
army of 80 yuan-ti coming.
Right.
Evacuate town.
Yes.
Save Tommy.
Okay. Save Jer.
Save Jer.
Right. Jer.
Save
Tommy. Who's Tommy?
Save Jer.
Find Tommy. Find Tommy. Meanwhile, grab Jer. Find Tommy.
Save Jer.
Save Jer. Kill hostage. Meet us in palace. You're in Sky Palace.
You said he got to the town, right?
Yeah. Meet us in Sky Palace. What else can we say?
How about instead of meet us in Sky Palace, we put we are raiding Sky Palace.
Yes.
That gives them a more direct idea of what we're doing with the plan.
We're raiding
Sky Palace.
Sky Palace, meet us there.
We're raiding Sky Palace.
I love your
conjecture. Put it all together.
Exactly.
We're raiding Sky Palace, meet us. Or just come.
Yeah. Like, meet us there.
Meet us there.
That's only 18 words.
Yes. Alright, we got 7.
I didn't say meet us there, I just said meet us.
How about steal Mare's gold? He's not gonna need it!
Evacuate Mare. Steal Mare's gold.
That's 17 words.
Go in there and say, hey Mare, for 800 gold, I'll tell you what's about to happen.
I'll predict the future.
Give me the money. Your town's about to be burned to the cinder. Give me the money.
That's it. I think that's all I need to say.
I think we have time to grab healing potions.
Like something about bring. I don't think. I think we might as well just get them there as quickly as possible. We don't want to give them extra tasks.
Yeah.
The sooner they can get to us, the better.
Yeah.
Yeah, but isn't it 4 hours down the mountain?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is why they need to leave some time. They're probably not even going to get anywhere close by the time we leave.
Yeah, they're not going to help in this adventure.
Yeah, true.
Maybe we can just send them, instead of telling them to meet us, we just say, lead the evacuation. Take everyone to safety and whatever.
I feel like...
No, because the yuan-ti are going to go after everybody, every living soul, and they don't want to be part of that group.
Yeah, I feel like you're going to want backup eventually. Or in this situation, your characters would feel like they were going to want backup eventually.
Not only that, we don't want the party split. We don't know where the people are going to go.
Yeah.
It's a little late for that, but...
Yeah. We're already party split.
Yeah, but this would be even bigger party split.
Yeah, that's true.
Because we have no idea where they are.
Yeah, that's true. Alright, so let's get some details on our plan so we know what to expect since we have the words. We're raiding Sky Palace. We'll release animals.
Fishbury Fountain.
So that brings us to 24. Please.
Please.
Okay, so what did it say? So, army of Indians coming, evacuate town, save your kill hostage, we're raiding Sky Palace, releasing mutants.
Okay. We're raiding Sky Palace, we'll release animals and destroy fountain. Meet us there, please.
Instead of please, why don't you sign it? What's your name?
They know who I am. They know the sensor.
Releasing mutants, destroying fountain, meet us there.
How about, did you say hurry?
That's 22. We're raiding Sky Palace, releasing mutants, destroying fountain, meet us there.
Hurry.
That's 22.
Did you say hurry?
Hurry.
Please.
Love you. Hurry. Love you. That's 25 minutes.
Hurry, good luck.
Or,
yes.
Tell my wife I love her. So, release mutants, destroying fountain, meet us there, please. Hurry.
Yeah.
And don't die.
Don't die.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, I have to take out, please.
Just a huge library of images that Jay had.
All right.
I like downloaded them forever ago.
So there's our message.
Alright. Army of Beta Yuan-ti coming. Evacuate town, save Jura, kill hostage. We're raiding Sky Palace, releasing you in this destroying fountain.
Meet us there. Hurry. Don't die.
Sounds good.
It's the best 25 words ever.
Message to... who are you sending the message to?
Let's see, who's there?
It's Doran, Gilrandi.
Oh, that's not much of a choice.
It's Doran, Gilrandi, Gwena, and that's it. And Jerry's a shrimp.
Honestly, Gwena.
Okay.
Oh! The only NPC.
Do you think Gilrandi is going
to go, whoa, dude, this is crazy.
And Doran.
And Captain at your service.
I haven't known him for as long as I've known Gwena.
Yeah.
I know Gwena is trustworthy at this point. And you can play Gwena, so what's her 25-word message back to me?
Oh, she... she says, holy...
and she says it 25 times.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's see. She says...
No, the holy's only one time. The other 24 words are...
Yeah.
Listen.
that seems like the best one to send it to, right?
Honestly. Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
I would have sent it to Jura, but...
she's leveled up, so I think she's a little more beast now, so... I don't think she can take an army of 80, though. I wish she could. I'd send her out there and let her do it. She'd have to give her 800 gold if she could kill them all.
I just realized I can use sending to find our dragon.
Really?
At least talk to the dragon.
Oh, wow. Nice.
I can just send the dragon a message.
But I don't think he'll come fight for us.
No, probably not. But
that'd be kind of cool if he would.
I can send it to a creature like the
you snakes! Voice. You filthy reptiles! Look at our dragon. He ain't filthy.
That's right.
Or I could send a message to Kermit the Hermit and have him come to his magical shack.
Teleport.
Maybe he can teleport here in his shack and start evacuating townspeople in it.
One at a time.
Good old Kermit the Hermit.
Hello, I'm Kermit the Hermit.
Hi there.
Hey there, Stevie. Okay, here's her 25-word message back. What in the name of all that is good and holy are you talking about? I'm freaking out right now. Just kidding, we're on.
And to you two, I just say, they've got everything under control.
All right, we go.
Okay, you double back. You go into Trouser Cave.
As soon as we're sure that they're clear of the area.
Yeah, they are all clear. You see, like, bloody bits, like, shredded in the bear traps and stuff.
We sent them back up.
For yourselves?
We know where they are.
Okay. So you can't necessarily not follow them.
It's legs if you see it.
Okay, so you set back up the bear traps. They've also, like, cleared away a bunch of the cow traps, so you just...
Yeah,
you're
not taking time for that. Bear traps will just be really quick.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you jump. You fall through the lens.
Have bracelets glow.
And you land in the Sky Palace.
And when we land there, there's even more men marching toward the goal.
Well, hopefully this place is mostly deserted.
Yes. There are a couple of guys, however, who see
one. Now you die!
And they're like, what the crap? Why are you not here?
No jokes.
We can.
Gentlemen?
Are they just the purebloods?
Yep, purebloods.
Split up handle one.
Time to make a count.
Mm-hmm. Gentlemen?
I'm keeping track.
You guys exactly go take care of business.
Many,
I'll handle this.
I'm keeping track of exactly how many yuan-ti are remaining in this fortress.
Do we want to attack all of them at once? Like one each? Or?
Yeah, I think we'd handle one each.
I got this one.
I'll take that guy.
I kind of thought so. You were kind of staring at him.
Well,
I need to be careful about my spells.
No. Okay.
This is one time, do not use spells recklessly.
Yeah, exactly. We need to save as much as we can.
Let's see.
Are we, these are pure bloods, meaning they're stronger?
No,
they're
the weak ones.
Okay. We should be able to take on one each pretty easily, right?
I think so.
Okay. Six damage, two, four,
that's not supposed to be hooked.
Nope, not at all.
That's where we're going.
Let's see here.
Actually, the same thing.
Alright, we're doing initiative.
Yep.
So, 18. Good. Good, though.
What level are we now?
Five.
What's your initiative, Andy?
I get to do 3 beams! I hadn't rolled it, sorry. I was asleep. I forget. We should have gone through there. 10.
Go, Andy. That's a 6.
They're not in initiative.
No,
they're out of here.
Don't
just the 3
it.
Of you.
Just the 3 of us. Alright, let's set the. We're not going to be using them in this session.
Okay. Please to be distributing the following. Let's go purple, white, and
so 3 beams.
Purple, white, and green.
Okay. All right. Done.
First is Eldrin.
Alright.
Eldrin. That's 3 times that.
That's 1d8. Okay. I will take out my longbow and. I'll just move up. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and use voice spread. He makes a con save.
Oh, okay.
Okay. There might be one of the resistance. Okay. Makes a con save.
Mm-hmm.
It has begun.
It gets a 7.
It does not succeed. It takes 15 poison damage.
Okay. It appears unaffected.
Dang it, that's a thought. Alright.
Yeah, I kind of knew they were immune to poison.
Yeah.
Velden? Assuming you're done?
Yeah.
Okay. Velden.
Unless I can move more.
You can keep on moving if you have more.
Yeah. 30, 35.
Okay. What was your spell? Poison cloud?
Poison
spray.
Spray. Yeah. It's 10 foot range. So.
I got damage.
This is my best damage, but they're going to do
it. Alright. I'm going to do Sacred Flame on the pink one, I guess.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
So it makes a dex save. DC 15.
This one is cold. But this one is are they like weak to cold or something?
Nope.
Failed?
Yeah.
Okay. So he takes 90 points of damage.
I think this was for what? What spell?
Sacred Flame.
Okay.
It's radiant damage.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going. Do we have ranged weapons out or melee weapons?
No, they have their melee weapons on either.
Using this one. I'll just move up a little bit.
Okay. Fairies.
Eldritch Blast. So, a 19 to hit.
Yes.
And it's going to take 19 damage.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, sorry, wait. 14 and 9. So, he's actually going to take 23 damage.
23. Okay.
You use both rays for that, I guess?
Yeah.
14? I thought it was
d12. D12 plus 2.
Oh, okay.
No, it's d10 plus 2.
So
sorry, I rolled the wrong guys.
Okay.
My bad. I got the wrong guys. Alright, let's try that again. So 11 and 6. 17.
Okay. Alrighty. Brian, this guy steps up and extends his hand in a noxious cloud.
He would do it.
You may attempt a constitution save.
Yes, I may.
Doing the exact same thing that you just did.
Yep.
That'd be 18 plus something or other. 19, wait. Yeah, 19.
19, okay. all right, you succeed, you take no damage.
Let's see.
This dude he's just gonna keep his sword. Okay, this guy is gonna try to poison the square you was saying. Please make a constitution sword.
10.
10?
Yeah.
Okay. You take 16 more poison. Alright, back to Elden.
Okay.
Yep.
60 feet. I'll have him make another con save.
Okay. 9.
Okay. He will take 4 cold damage. And has disadvantage on the next weapon attack roll.
Okay.
I'll just kind of scoot back.
I'm sorry. Yeah, that's fine.
We'll do the same thing. So he makes a dex save.
Nope.
Takes 11 damage.
Okay.
I wish I had a better cantrip.
Mm-hmm. There it is.
Same. 16 to hit.
Yes.
And I'm also going to, with both things, I'm going to put 10 feet per beam, so I'm going to knock him back 20 feet.
Okay.
First one's going to be 10, second one's going to be 7, so it takes another 17.
Okay. This guy will try to strike you. Two more attacks. No, both misses. Alright, thing that guy will try to hit you. I rolled a 4, a 5, a 2, and a 3.
I like those rolls.
10, 15,
do a blast and then run back.
So can't get all right, well, Andy, unfortunately, Darius took some
misses.
Does an 18 hit you?
Yes.
And a crit definitely hits you.
Well, no.
Yeah, put your anti-crit spray on.
I had an anti-crit roughness.
All right, so you take 3 from the first and 10 from the crit. 13. Back to
Elwood. Now I'm gonna. Doug, yes, he's in melee with me. I'll just give him the old quarterstaff then, I suppose. Okay. You have 20 to hit.
Yeah, okay, so guys, pure bloods have armor class 11.
Okay.
We'll see.
And then 5 bludgeoning.
5 bludgeoning against screen.
Yeah, okay. The old quarter staff that I haven't used since like the first session probably.
It's super effective.
Sweet.
Double.
Same thing.
Okay.
What saving throw?
Oh yeah. What is it? Dex save?
Yeah.
10.
I hit him for 16.
Nice.
Max damage.
That was radiant damage?
Yeah.
Bang on 7, right?
Okay, various.
7.5.
Barriers.
7.5.
Every second diagonal is.
Alright, so 21 to hit. Of course, that's going to be a hit.
Are you rolling separately for each spray?
I didn't think you had to when you had to do them together.
You are supposed to roll separately for each round.
Awesome. Plus, let's go see for that thing. Thanks a lot.
New side of yuan-ti!
It's for 6 damage. It's going to push him back for 10 feet. And I'm going to move. He's going to go back.
Oh, that's 5.
That's 10. That's all.
We can shift a little bit. 6.
Okay.
He's starting to show any signs of being hurt.
Yeah.
Maybe we should have concentrated.
Say what now?
So maybe we should have concentrated our attacks.
Anything hits you, Brad?
It does.
Okay. You took 2 damage from the first attack. Is it 14 hit?
No.
Okay.
Just open for Brad. These are only 3 guys in the whole building.
Okay, yeah, Fane, he misses you twice. And he's not in range. End of this round of combat, the door swings open.
Someone say something, didn't you?
Are they more privileged?
They are the powerful little ones.
Okay.
Now,
moderate ones. Yes.
Yeah. Yes, you'll know the abominations when you see. This is not good. So they get to there and there.
Time to go there.
Please put blue and black.
You can do bear if you want to, and I'll stay in that for a while.
Yeah.
But then you can't talk to us.
Yeah.
Okay, they get to there. That's all I can do. Okay, back to Elwin.
I think I will do that.
I will
transform myself into evil wild bear. Ground bear, I should say.
Get behind me!
Which way I'm running?
Draws 2, 6. Okay.
You have your bear trail?
Oh, why is it? Thank you for asking. Okay. Bite is 10. claws are 12, so claws hit for 2d6, that's 5, plus 4 is 9 damage.
So a total of 9 damage?
Yep.
Okay. I'll get there, eventually.
Let's see. Okay, Billy. Yeah, that pushing the guy back helps in this case. With his
name open. Yeah, keep him off me.
Yeah, you save yourself 2 attacks at least.
Now what I'm going to do with the 2 behind me? Push him out the door and close it?
I can get those 2 from where I am now, but I'd rather not use them, just 2.
Yeah.
Should I go for a second level spiritual weapon? That was a good use of that. Look, it could be.
Yeah, I mean, I think we can start burning some spell slots at this point.
Okay, spiritual weapon. Well, first I'm going to cast the same thing on this guy. The sacred flame.
Okay.
So, dex save.
16.
Okay, success. So then I do spiritual weapon and attack him. Miss.
Okay, Ferris.
And I will
So
move.
First attack on him. It's a hit with a 16. He takes 6 damage.
That is right. Okay, take 6.
Yep.
Okay.
He's still up.
Yep.
All right, I'm gonna hit him with a second attack. It's a 23, and he also takes 6 damage. Okay.
All right.
And then I'm gonna move.
15.
Yeah.
5, 10, 15, 20.
You're here.
Yeah. 5, 10, 15, 20. Right.
Then 15.
You can go diagonal.
Yeah.
Oh. Never mind. So that's 15 that way? So I just keep going diagonal?
Yeah. So 20, then 25, 30. Yeah.
Right here?
Yep.
Okay. And pushed him back 20 feet. So
you can run there and then go if you want.
Okay, so pushing back 20 feet.
Mm-hmm.
That's in a straight line, right?
Yep.
So he's going to wind up here?
Yeah.
Yep. Cool. Alright.
I'm going to keep ping-ponging him around. Keep him off me.
Alright, pure blood misses you twice, bone. Alright, pure blood hits thing once for 4 damage. Yep. And this guy tries feebly to run on this treadmill. And these guys go. All right. let's see.
What
so, Andy does a 17.
Yes, it is me.
Does a 16.
Yes, it is me.
Yikes! These guys are tough for sure.
I'm gonna drop. I'm gonna feel a little bit. Is that how much damage you're taking?
No.
That's all I got.
You take 14, including the poison damage from. And then the scimitar deals another 8.
14 and 8?
Yeah.
What's that? 22. I'm almost down.
Okay.
We can't reserve our spells. So
does a 17 hit you?
Yeah.
No? Okay. So,
20 is my AC.
Okay. Yikes.
Okay, yeah, we can't hold back anymore.
Yeah.
Alright, it is now Eldwin's turn.
So that would be a, let's see, first a 17 plus whatever. And that's the max damage. So it would be 12 piercing damage to green.
Okay, he drops.
Alright. So another attack. So I will turn and take this guy out.
Yeah, charge him.
That guy's almost dead. I'll kill him on my next turn.
Okay. One, two, three. And then the other one is 19 plus something. Almost max damage. 11 plus 4 is 15.
15, yes.
That guy.
Okay. Next is Velvin.
Alright. I think I'll use Radiance of the Dawn. So all of the enemies make a Constitution save.
DC, all of them?
All of them.
Okay.
DC 15.
Alright. So the, let's see, there's two pure bloods left. DC 15?
Yeah.
Both the pure bloods failed. And both the Malazans fail.
Hey, everyone takes 21 damage.
Holy crap!
Oh, boy!
What spell was that?
That's my Radiance of the Dawn.
Both the pure bloods drop.
Oh, man.
Both the pure bloods drop.
These two? Okay.
But I only get it once per short rest, so. And I rolled almost max damage.
Okay. Now it's Ferris.
So that's around. Wait, wait, that wasn't done.
No.
I also do my spiritual weapon attack on. That guy's hurt, right? More hurt.
Yeah. He's
hurt. So I'll spiritual weapon on him.
Okay.
Okay.
Where's the other jerk blood? He took him off over.
Okay.
Yeah, an 11 doesn't hit that, right?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, I know you were. Mirror self.
Alright, Ferris.
I'm gonna turn and blast the guy beside me. Alright, so both hit 12 and then a 24. Huh?
He's stronger. He's got a higher armor class. His armor class actually used 12. So, on this
side. Oh, okay. Awesome. Then I do make it. So 6 and 9, so 15 damage.
Alright.
And actually, I'm going to push him for 20 feet. And I'm going to move. So that's 15? No, that's
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 5.
Okay, that's good.
Okay. All right, so he's gonna run up and try to attack up there.
Have you hit him?
Misses both times.
All right, I'm gonna give disadvantage on the first attack.
No, that's good. Yes. Yeah, hit once.
That's a miss. Second attack misses. All right, this is your window because it's going really low. So it is now Elwin's turn.
Okay, I will continue.
I'm gonna take these two guys down before two more come through door one. I'm gonna heal myself.
Does a
I got a potion that can
heal. Yes.
Okay.
I'm kind of saving it back though.
Case. Four, so that's 8 piercing.
Okay.
And then this is higher than that, so 3 plus 5 is 8 plus 4 is 12 slashing.
He goes down.
Sweet.
Alright, Velvet.
Okay, I'm going to attack the spiritual weapon first.
Okay.
Hit for 7 damage.
Yep.
And he's still up, I assume, yes. You get to go before he does, right?
I think so, yeah. I can blast him
yes,
twice.
Yes, Ferris, go before he does.
Okay, yes, please do that.
I'm going to blast him twice.
I'm not just going to stand here and eat crumpets.
I'll use a sacred flame again.
Sacred flame. What is your regular weapon?
It's my plus one mace, but it does d6 plus 3, which is fiddly.
What is your spell do?
2d8.
Okay.
What have you done to him so far?
He got the 21 from your spirit.
Yeah, you haven't really been using it, have you?
No, I've never used it since my cantrip went up in power.
Okay. Good.
I know it's supposed to get better as I do or something, but
I don't know.
Your mace, you just don't want to use it, basically.
It's weaker than everything else. It has a better chance to hit, I guess.
The cantrip deals, sorry, how much damage again?
Well, he makes a dex save. DC 15.
He makes it.
Okay, then does not.
What does it do if he fails?
2D.
2D. Alrighty, Farius, your turn.
I do need to try out the mace, but not in a life or death situation.
Yeah.
Alright, so let's try 17 and a...
Are you in range?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
The whole room is my range.
Okay.
240 feet.
Okay. As you are casting your spell, you look over to door number 2.
Ah!
And it flies open and out slithers.
Holy crap.
It's still there. Two spaces in the air.
Okay,
and you look over and some.
First hit is a 17, second hit is going to be a 13.
That's good.
Okay. First one is for 5 damage. Second one is for 9 damage. And he's going to be pushed for 20 feet.
Ooh, okay. Those doors are still open if they came through.
Goodbye. Thanks for playing.
Yep.
Have a nice day.
It is now his turn.
He's going to come right back at me.
Well, I got him off of you for a second.
I'll give him disadvantage again.
Okay.
Sorry, I tried to need it. That's all I can do.
He got his lowest was a 17.
It's a miss.
It's a miss? Okay.
Right, 20 is.
And then he rolled one, so he missed again.
You're alive.
You are alive, yeah.
Sounded like the disadvantage helped.
Yes. Edwin.
You want to go after the big guy?
Can you reach him? Actually, I would suggest you go after him. You help me finish this guy off.
Alright.
You just keep pushing him back. Delay the battle.
Okay.
You can push him back even though he's large, right?
Yeah, there's no science restriction.
No.
You can push dragons.
Nice.
And for my turn, I step right there. Can I take that at the end of the turn? I didn't move.
This is Elden.
I just started my turn.
I just want to look at him and go.
Does a 12 hit this guy?
Yes.
Alright. So
he's gonna be hard on the hit though.
Slashing.
Okay.
And then,
is he hard on the hit? Anybody's big?
No.
Okay.
Okay. So 7 slash.
Yeah.
Alright. Zeldin.
Spiritual weapon. How much damage do you do to him?
7.
Okay.
And
okay. Nice.
I guess sacred flame again.
Okay.
So dex save.
Okay.
You got a 15.
Just made it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And I'm going to shift over here, away from the abomination of the Lord.
Do you spirit weapon on?
I've been trying. I missed the last couple. Or at least this one.
Okay. We are back to here. Let's see. After this. Okay, Madison. So that was your turn, right,
yeah.
Okay, Farius.
Does a 17 and a 21 hit?
Both hit.
Okay. The first beam is going to be 6 damage, second beam is going to be 7 damage,
okay.
And he's going to get knocked back. You're not welcome!
Oh my gosh, that's crazy. Each one is 10 feet.
Yeah. That's insane.
And when he gets higher level, he fires off 3 or 4 or 5 beams at once. Last guy's 50 feet away.
It's crazy.
Alright, he's going to.
And the big bear grabs him by the throat, rips it out.
We got 2 18s to him.
Yep.
Damn.
What's the major damage at?
What's your AC?
11.
You got seven on the first hit and 9 on the second.
We need to make you a
studded elven. Skin off a bear. I'm gonna pay for that.
I'm a druid. I can't wear any metal armor.
Yeah.
Thanks so. Definitely a hit.
Unless you put barding on. Just say what?
9 damage.
Yuan-ti scale.
15 damage.
Second hit brings
me. All right.
Okay.
So far, it's working.
This isn't really what we wanted to do, though. We wanted to have them go call their friends back. So we need to survive until we can do that, but if we wipe everyone out this year, then we didn't really win.
Not so. I considered a part.
If there's a treasure chest at the end of this, we won.
Okay.
Especially if it's like more than 800 gold. The mayor
yeah.
I call that a win. I call surviving this a win. This is where I'm open my mouth and say, I hope that's the last door that opens.
Do you guys have any like healing potions or healing magic?
We have some.
Yeah.
One potion each.
Yeah.
I have one potion.
I still have one.
Okay, so spiritual weapon, 10, 15, 20.
It doesn't do much.
That's as far as it can move. Mm-hmm. I am going to.
I have 10 poison arrows, but it won't work on these guys.
I don't know whether advance or retreat. If I'll just move over, and I will spend my action to use a healing kit on myself.
Okay.
And that is it.
All right, there it is.
So, blossom. All right, so we have a 20 to hit. Oh, and a natural 20.
Nice.
Yes. Let's roll the confirm crit.
You don't roll the confirm, you just crit.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, never mind. Okay, that's a 20 then.
Do it.
I'm sorry, I'm used to the old system. We'll put my 20 back up there.
So you just roll double your dice and add your bonus once.
Okay, so the first blast is going to be 7 damage.
Okay.
Second blast is going to be 12, and then you just add it one time, right? The bonus plus 12 2? 12
for what? To hit?
Plus 2 is for...
No, damage on the second beam.
That
was a crit die.
Plus
and
2.
And then plus 2 on top, so 14. 14.
Yeah, plus 2 per beam, yeah.
Okay.
Well,
the
2 is going to crit.
Gotcha. Yeah. Yeah.
So 14 plus 7, so a total of
21.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you push him another.
Another 20 feet.
At all?
He hasn't had his turn yet. He's about to. Okay. So after Farius, yeah, now it's his turn. So move him 80 feet forward.
Holy crap.
Double moves.
Yep.
Sorry, guys. He's in the room.
you already pushed him back.
You kept him off a major attack. So, it is now against him.
Mm.
Oh, wait. Before you take a turn, can I run backwards?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't know if I exactly want to engage 10, 15, him right 20, now.
20, 25. That's about as far. I'm not going to stand in the doorway. As far as back, I'm going to go. See if I can 10, blast him again. 15.
25, 30, 35, 40. I guess I could double move too.
Yeah.
15, 20,
25.
Wish I could run.
Well, then your turn.
If you can hit me, no matter what I do. So. I first attack with spiritual weapon. Does an 11 hit him?
No.
Then I will attack with...
Do we get bonuses for flanking?
Yeah, you get advantage. Actually, I'm not going to attack again. I'm going to double move. That's the only way I can not get hit, I think. I don't have time to end this. I should have this way.
Do you have a ranged weapon? Other than your weapon?
I do.
Yeah, we've got time.
It's not great. I just wanted to double move to get back, so.
Yeah. I was gonna say, if we can keep a distance between us as long as we can, keep beating on him, wear him down a little bit.
This is our last round of not getting hit.
Yeah, it's very, Fairy's his turn now.
Push him, push him.
Push.
I can push him, but the problem I'm looking at is I got 3 hit points. If I don't push him back far enough, he comes in and hits me.
He can't. He can't run that far and attack.
Yeah, that was a double move.
So yeah, oh, was it?
Turn to get that far.
Yeah. Oh. Okay. Yeah.
I'll heal you next round, I guess, since I'm not going to use my magic. All
right. So a 15 and a 23. Do they hit?
Both hit.
Both hit. Okay. All right. 12 for the first one.
Okay.
And 5 for the second
one.
So 17.
Okay. Alright, move him 40 feet ahead. So let's see.
Alright. At least. Like 51. I didn't know who else hit him, so I didn't even know where else to stand.
Yeah, no one else has.
Oh, sure. Let me beat on the big guy. All alone.
Okay, so it moves up like that, and then before your eyes, it transforms from its, like, you know, humanoid or whatever, like its upper body, into a giant snake. Just like all its arms are like, folded, it just like and rears its head back and it's good for it.
I should be running out of room to go.
I'll bring it back to you.
You can do that.
So then do what?
Just run through the room and close the door.
Yeah. But then he'll probably just transform him back. And...
Well, we don't know what's up here.
Yeah. I'm going to say I guess I can't really communicate with the guys anymore. I look over at you and shrug my shoulders.
Yep. Ready in attack?
I stand up on my hind legs and go like this.
Ready to bite and claw.
Yeah. That's my turn.
You only get one attack, I think.
Ready? Yeah. Even with multi attack, okay.
Okay. So
you ready in attack for when he comes in here?
Okay. Let me double check that. How far does he move in one turn?
He can move up to 80.
That's a double.
Yeah.
What can he move in one
normal
turn? 40?
Yeah.
So it's 10, 20, 30, 40.
Mm-hmm.
So this would be a double range here.
5, 10, 15, 20. Maybe his normal movement is 20. Do you know anything?
What's his normal movement?
Yeah, I think it's normal.
So 40?
So
40. 40 is his normal.
Yeah, so he could get 2 out here. It's 8 squares.
So he can just barely reach any of us. And then attack.
Yeah, I'm going
to
burn a...
Okay, when you're ready, you get to do any one action. So
it's my turn. It's my turn to come up before his?
Yes.
So if I can blow him back again.
Yeah, if you hit him at least once, then we should be safe for one more round.
Mm-hmm.
And that's definitely the last
time. I can hit him for
yeah.
once. I can hit him for once. I've been rolling pretty good. So I'm pretty sure I hit him for once.
I'm gonna use one of my spell slots to gain some HP.
I'm getting 5 points on my spell attack.
So it's a bonus action?
Mm-hmm.
15 hit him last time. So 15 hits him.
Okay.
As long as I roll a 10 or a higher on one attack.
Okay, so yeah, you can ready any normal action, which would include all of your attacks if they're if they're not bonus attacks. But it also uses your reaction. That's the concept.
Gotcha. When I did cold damage to him, did it seem to be extra effective at all, or?
Let's go to the next.
Hit for 5.
Okay.
And then I will swing around here. Can I speed by that way?
You're right there.
Right.
So 1, 2, 3.
You can squeeze through 2 of the bare spaces. No, you can stand, or you can't stand, but you can squeeze through that one.
Can we just end up here?
With a normal move? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, you can end up
there. There she is. 3, 4. Yeah. I'm trying to get to you to heal you. As long as you blast him, I'll be okay here. So I'll just stand there. And use my hero gifts. So you recover 10 points. It's better than nothing.
Eighteen and a 15,
both hit.
And a 9 and a 10, so 19 damage. And he gets pushed back for 20.
Hope the speed isn't too much faster in this thing.
Shush!
Okay.
He's gonna spit on us.
Will everyone please make a wisdom save?
That's 20. Mm-hmm. 15.
Mm-hmm.
Wisdom save.
Where's wisdom save?
How do you calculate the save DC for a caster again?
Oh, you just add the 2?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah, 15 there.
Because I rolled a 13.
Yeah.
Depends on their challenge rating.
Okay.
But
I don't think it's good for me.
Whatever their challenge rating is, that's their level, so they use that proficiency bonus.
Mm.
If it's 5 or higher, then it would probably be 3. I don't think you'd send anything too high.
Okay.
So that made 11 plus casting ability score.
Okay.
Should be the DC for him.
11 plus without the proficiency bonus?
It includes
proficiency. Oh, that includes. So it's 8 plus proficiency bonus plus
yeah.
Ability score? Okay. Alright. And what did everybody get?
I got 15.
I'm going to use a luck point.
Alright, a little bit better. 18.
Okay. Nothing happens to any of you. Well done.
Do we feel anything?
You feel slightly...
looked at?
Slightly about to poop your pants.
Oh, that's right. The last one is the fear.
Your turn.
Okay. I will...
stare him in the eyes and snarl.
Yeah. Are we sure that... We're pretty sure he's going to get to us next turn? Okay.
Unless we run.
Okay. I will.
And you can't open the door.
Wait, so I'm going to get to go, and then you'll get to go before he goes?
The 3 of you will go, and then he'll go.
I could move up and attack. And
it'll be
you
about in various things.
I want to be in front anyway.
Either of us can be in front. I've got 1 hit points now.
Okay.
You got 20.
I guess if I'm ready my attack. Okay, so I'll move up there, use my bonus action to regain a little bit more HP. and then ready my attack. Get back five. One of them.
Alright, buddy.
And spiritual weapon. Yeah, spiritual weapon first. Hit for 10.
Okay.
So he's taking
around
70, I think.
85.
85? Yeah. Oh, yeah, I didn't count your last couple.
That's right. That's right.
I'm counting every point. I'm hoping he drops real soon.
Okay.
And I guess I'll attack with Sacred Flame. Since he's close enough, so death save.
It's more comfortable when he's 240 feet away.
15.
Yeah, he makes it.
Okay.
I think you're going to wind up using that mace.
That's going to be a failure. He didn't attack through you?
Yeah. He ignores cover.
Oh, that sucks. One of these missed.
Not hit him.
Nope.
18 is the second one.
Yep.
And he takes 6 points of damage. And he drops!
Okay.
I want to move.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to hide behind the bear.
15, 20, so here you can attack.
Okay.
Take him out.
That'd be perfect. Is it important enough to roll that? With my claws, I get a 15 to hit.
Yep.
Okay, so that's 8 plus 3, 11 damage.
Okay.
Still up?
Okay.
I don't want to waste a luck point or use a luck point on that. Should I? To try and hit with my other one?
When you know you missed?
Yeah. Pretty nice.
What?
I can't
find
out the... Yeah, for the bite.
How much does it break you?
D8 plus 4.
Max 12. It could put us over.
Probably not working on the left. We might need those here.
Yeah, exactly. I'll just save on that. What was that? 8 to hit. So, yeah, that's a miss.
Okay. That was Elvin. Okay,
yep.
So then he finishes his move. And the brain has attacked.
He's going to swallow one of them.
Does anybody have any effects? Before he begins with attack.
Effects? What do you mean effects?
Thane has some stuff.
I have my personal things that I'd like to will to my family.
personal effects.
Yeah.
I guess his first attack, or if he looks like he's attacking me with any of his major attacks, I'll give him disadvantage.
Okay.
But, yeah, bite or...
Well, he's a snake, so all he can do is bite and constrict.
Yeah, so I guess disadvantage on whatever attack roll comes first to me.
So he will try to bite you. Yep, he missed. Not good.
We have one more for those.
A 20 hits there, right?
Yep.
Okay, he constricts you.
Mm-hmm.
You are grappled, and you take... 11 damage.
Okay.
You are restrained, and he cannot constrict another target.
So now you can't move.
And now it is Elvin. It's your turn. So the DC is 14.
Mm. And the bear's strength, so that helps.
I believe you have to use your action to try to escape.
What was the DC again?
14.
Okay.
Yeah, so you can attack, but you have disadvantage. It has advantage against you to attack, and you have disadvantage on dex.
Yes. Okay, dex saves. Mm-hmm. And so my choices are either to attack or try to escape?
Yeah.
Attack with disadvantage.
Attack with disadvantage or try to escape.
I had already made my roll. It was 13, so I barely failed this game.
That was it.
The bonus action you want to spend?
I can use more first level spell slots to regain more hit points.
You want to?
Yeah, I mean, they're pretty worthless battles, so I'm just going to do that.
Okay. I'm going to shift around to get into a future position for flanking. Unless you count that as flanking, but he can still attack. So.
Yeah, it's three times concurrent.
Okay.
That each spell is first, and your slot level is current. So yeah, it is 3d12.
Okay, for 7.
Alright.
And then.
If we've already been
down,
use
one base, so that I actually get the advantage.
I'll just keep using.
Okay. As you reel back to swing, you feel like almost like a vibration in your face. Feels like it's
like
coming
in the tower
or something.
Okay, well, by my records, I rolled a 14 to hit.
Okay, you miss.
Okay. Unless it was more powerful than.
Okay.
I rolled really badly on that one.
Fairies.
I'm gonna blast it. No. First one is an 11, which is going to be a miss. Second one is a 19 plus 5, 24.
24 to hit, yep.
And 19, it's only 20s for crits, right?
Yep.
I think we have to see this battle go a few more rounds. Just
nice he takes
rounds of 3 damage.
Oh my gosh. Let me see.
Gonna go on to do that.
Did you do damage to him?
Yeah.
A little bit. 7. I did 7.
Okay.
Alright. So that was Ferris. Okay.
It gets pushed back into the.
It's got some apples.
Yeah, don't do that. Just don't
take
it.
Him with it. It's gonna take. Bye-bye,
bear!
No.
it's like coils.
Wait. No. Grappling, I think, ends if you push someone out of reach of it.
I would rule that he will carry him with him because it's a snake raptor and another object. Kind of pushing that would automatically cause him to lose. It would be one thing if you were like grabbing around to him with hands, but he's like coiling around.
So the condition also. An effect removes the grappled creature from the reach of the grappler or grappling effect, such as when a creature is hurled away by the Thunderwave spell. This is practically the same thing.
Yeah,
and it specifically
but,
says that.
Yeah, but he's constricted. He's like, he's coiled around, and it's different from holding on with both hands. Plus, he's got a reach of 10 feet with it, so if he got pushed back 10 feet, he'd slowly. Alright, so he's going to try to bite down, and that'll hit.
So you can attack without disadvantage now. He's been flanking.
That's true.
Assuming you're still alive.
That's true.
So he deals 16 to you with his bite attack.
Okay.
And back to Owen.
This is a constrict.
No, there's no ongoing damage. There's only damage on the hit. And then he gains the damage. At least that's what it says. Doesn't say there's only ongoing.
Okay, so since I'm flanking, it cancels out the disadvantage post attack.
Yep.
And that's 9. Yeah, 9 damage.
9 damage, okay.
And then a 14.
14 misses.
Okay.
Alright, Calvin.
I'm gonna try my mace first before this very
okay.
No.
Okay, spiritual weapon hits for 7.
Okay.
I rolled a 1 and a 4. Hmm. Last time I rolled 4 and a 8.
Alright, well, the spiritual weapon brings it down. So the coils relax in its head.
Oh, my goodness.
And you look around and listen, and no, 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 what's going on for the time being.
That's what we wanted.
That's true. Yes, it is.
Okay, I see. We carry these bodies back to the portal and start throwing them in.
That's all the way.
Yeah, we're not going
at the end. Yeah, you don't have the time or the.
I can make myself invisible, pick up one of the smaller guys, and make it look like he's walking down the hall.
What?
You wanted to bring back the other soldiers, didn't you?
Yeah, they didn't leave anyone in the cave.
To see, we don't know that.
We just walked through the cave.
Now's not the time for frippery.
Wait a minute, when did we walk through the cave?
To get here.
Yeah, I'll be a fripp.
Quit fripping
around. What about the other end of the cave? Two legs of a trouser.
You can see both ends when you walk in.
Yeah.
At the belt line, you can see it?
There's no one there.
God, who knew you could see it if you undo the belt?
Okay. So,
okay.
Never mind.
No way.
How many bear hit points do you have left?
I have 26.
Is it worth staying in bear form?
I have 8.
So yeah, I guess it's worth staying for now.
Yeah.
One hit.
I have taken a lot of damage.
I can't heal anyone else with the healing kits until we take a short rest.
Okay. Alright, well,
what's a short rest?
An hour.
Ooh. If it's all the things in the immediate vicinity, then we
go through this door towards
the... Yeah. I think you're right that we didn't accomplish our goal of getting them to send someone to recall the army, but at least we can set these guys free. And
if we can pick the lock?
Yeah, if we can smash it or something.
Yeah, we don't have locks.
Yeah.
They're each in their own separate cages, and there's a lock on every cage.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, maybe you can Eldritch Blast them.
Yeah.
Do it enough times, some lock will break.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe. Going back to that map the guy drew out for us, was there a back entrance to these things, or was it only through that one door?
A back entrance
to the cages.
To the cages? You can do the mouse thing. Maybe.
Yes, it looks like we can go around, I think. I don't quite understand this map.
Okay.
That's because it's written in yuan-ti.
Either way, I should probably get going soon.
So, if you're going, can we circle around that?
Seems
like you kind of changed things.
Yeah, I did a little bit. Yeah, there's no hallway going around there. But you could go like through here down this hallway and then come through there.
I held up there, you. There should be a slice of pizza.
Alright, so.
Actually, now you're there.
So there should be a back entrance. We haven't been down that way.
Okay.
Do you want to do that, or do you want to go through the arena and try to see what happens with the magic wall?
Let's test out the magic wall first. Since we know that it's there. What would be the advantage of going through that entrance?
Just not having to worry about that wall.
Oh, okay.
And having to get the gate open here, too.
Wasn't it with the magic wall, if you're wearing the bracers, you can't go through it?
Mm-hmm.
Can we just put our bracers in the bag holding and then go through? So that they're in a different dimension?
Okay. I'm concerned about getting back, though.
Mm. Then we can probably just find the
bang one of the bodies. I assume there's one of those bracers on it, or bracelets or whatever. Okay, so drag one of the bodies into the arena with us, and chuck it with the equipment, just to make sure it still works the way we think it does, at the wall.
Just throw it onto my back.
See if all the living things or whatever's wearing the razor.
Okay. You're going to chuck it at the invisible barrier?
Yeah.
With the thing on?
Yeah.
It bounces off.
Okay. So remove that, and then just the bracelet itself, hit it against the wall.
It bounces off.
Okay. So we take the guy's the body, throw it over, and see if we can pull it back out. Like, tie a rope to it or something. Toss it over, and then pull it back out.
On what? What are you talking about?
We're taking a dead guy, throwing him through the barrier and back. Okay, seeing if we can go through both ways.
Okay, so as soon as, like, a part of his body goes through, it won't come back.
That's what I thought. Okay, while he's partially through that, I slip the band on the other arm and try to pull him out.
He comes back.
That's
okay.
So you can only get in. You can only get in without one arm, and you can only get out with one arm.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, put them all in the bag of holding. Everyone goes through. We put them back on and we can get out.
Exactly.
Just trust me, it works.
Okay, I get that, but why would they design it that way?
So that they can't get trapped inside of the animals, probably.
Yeah. Like only...
The only thing that can get out is something that has the jewelry on. Mm.
So how did they get in there?
Take off the jewelry.
And come up with it. Oh, they got another way in?
There's another way in?
So that if they get trapped in the arena somehow from the back way, they can still get out. All the animals can't follow them.
So, but we can get in here now.
So if our plan is to set the animals loose and let them run amok, how do we allow them to get into the
We want to open up the back entrance also.
Okay. So we should check that out first.
Yeah. See what the animals are, too. If they're all in separate cages, we can take a good look at them.
Yeah. So we'll hop down, do that, and then we'll go and check the cages.
Everyone
and see.
Put the bracelets on first. Open up the gate. Can we just open it?
You're talking about
in the
arena? We can just open it.
Okay. We go in and look into the cages.
What you see in the cages defies description. You can see like traces of all different, like the guy said, like all different kinds of both animals and like magical creatures and beasts and everything from trolls to rabbits. And they're all just hideously mutated from extra limbs to like sores all over them to growths and like spines kind of.
So we don't want to touch them, period, in the story.
Yeah, like a lot of them, like as you walk by the cages, they're like gnash at the cage.
Does it seem like they're all stronger than the base animals would have been, maybe?
And messed up, and they like they're just mean and they don't know what's going on.
Hey, Yanti, dude, show true fear. When we said those cages were open.
Oh, yeah, he was terrified.
Okay, so look around for keys or anything to open cages.
Well, how are they locked?
With like, iron padlocks.
Okay. I didn't know if they were, like, drop gates or something
keys.
Like that.
Yeah.
Iron padlocks can be smashed off.
You actually see, like, in a lot of the cages, there's, like, drying puddles of, like, the different colored liquids in the fountain.
So that's where the water's going.
No, it's, like with, like, water dishes. Like, that they're feeding to the animals.
Oh, is it?
To gauge their reaction.
What are you saying? It's coming from the fountain?
No, they're just little like puddles everywhere, like they were splashing it on them or feeding it to them.
Oh, I see. Testing them.
Yeah.
Let's head to the back and see if we can get that open.
Okay. Go to the back entrance.
Okay. Through to the back or around to the back?
As long as nothing looks like it can be just through the cages, we'll go through.
Yeah, it's just, like I said, a plus sign hallway, so the hallway goes right back in there. So, you get to the back, and it's locked, but it locks from the inside.
Okay. So open that lock.
Open that, yep.
No keys around here either.
Or actually, no, I'm sorry, it'll lock from the outside.
Okay.
Yeah.
Keep the animals in.
Yeah, so it's locked.
Okay.
So you want to go around again?
Yeah. Yeah, so we go back up the way we came, down the hallway, around, and to
okay.
the door.
Yeah, so you definitely could have that running into it.
Okay.
Did you say you wanted to stop here, or?
Should probably, yeah.
How are we going to do it when everyone else comes back?
That's true. I guess combat has been going significantly faster this time around.
It has, yeah. It's
just I could probably play a little longer, yeah.
Okay. Alright, so when you get to that first corner junction there, just a little, like, widening area, you see a trio of guys come up on you.
Okay.
Two pure bloods in the mouths, and see, like, round the corner, and then this
do you want to threaten them, say, call back your troops before we destroy this fortress or something?
Yeah, let's do that.
Might as well start with that.
Then they're like, we're not scared of you, you're just screaming these little dudes.
Who have already slain two of your abominations.
And we've already brought hundreds of other men that are going through your palace right now.
Cool, good for you, let's fight.
Intimidation check?
You can make an
can I roll deception? See if they believe me?
They don't care. They don't fight.
Okay, well, fine. I do care. I don't mean in front.
Intimidate.
No, you're not in front.
You try intimidate?
No. You're good at that.
Tell me? Intimidate.
I try and intimidate.
Okay. They're not going to run. He's like a leather bug. He wants to fight. Oh, I rolled a natural 20! With a plus 5.
You scared them into fighting.
That's what I thought. You all shall die! Okay.
Like, that's what we're here for, bro.
Fine. Then die, you shall.
Right.
Is this our marching order?
Sure.
I should probably be.
Thank you. I need a shield.
Alright, roll initiative.
6. Four.
11.
17. Time to get this party started.
Yeah, 6 players does slow down combat a lot.
Way significant. My favorite is 3 players. I don't know why. I just like it a lot. Farius, you're up first.
Alright, let's try a 16 and an 8.
Okay.
That was blast.
Those two.
This guy right here in front.
It'll be the 16 hits.
Alright. Try a 3 points of damage and push him back.
Okay.
Sorry, bad roll.
Yeah.
He knew it was going to happen sooner or later. Can't all be great.
Velder?
Well, that just pushed him out of my range. So, we're sorry, Lee. I'll make a dex save.
Yes.
Okay. Then I will move up to here.
Okay. There you go.
Can I borrow one purple D6, please?
Why, yes.
I think it's not.
How about a green one?
No, that's all right. It's color coded.
Okay.
Yeah, this is my bite. This is my bite. Thanks, and it's after all. Gotcha.
15 misses you right there?
Yeah.
Okay.
I should heal a little bit more.
Is it 16 for you?
No.
Okay. Brian, 18 hits in the barrel.
Yep.
Okay, I take 2.
No.
It's Odin's turn.
Mm-hmm.
Stop.
Stay up there. I think we kind of want him to turn back and give us some healing. Just heal the party, because you don't use your spells for much else.
That's true.
And I use my spells for all sorts of other things.
Yeah, I just didn't prepare any healing this time.
At all?
No. That's using them for other things. Okay, so that one definitely hits, and that's an 8 damage.
Against two.
Who's been hurt so far?
Just him.
I'll do green.
You can't reach him.
Yeah, you can't reach
him. I'll do black.
So black against the green. And how much?
8.
8 damage, okay.
And then 13 to hit?
Yes.
4, 5, 6, 7, 11 damage.
Okay, now back to Curtis.
Then I'll use my bonus to get a little bit more. 8.
So gonna blast both guys. First one's gonna be a 23.
Which guys?
Sorry. Huge blast on both on same guy. That's what I meant to say. Yeah.
Okay.
23 and
18.
We're looking at 12 and then another 10, so 22 total. And he's pushed for 20 feet.
Should I do a few more spells?
Oh, and I want to back up 10 feet. Probably
not.
Huh?
You probably shouldn't.
Mm. You shouldn't?
Yeah, oh. You shouldn't.
I was like, I shouldn't have 10 feet? What's behind me?
I mean, I've only actually used 2 so far, but...
I don't need to be close to anybody.
I'll just do another sacred flame on green.
The best parts about being warlock.
On green?
Okay.
Best cantrips.
Yeah, he passes.
You know what I should do next round? Stand in front and take the dodge action. Every attack has disadvantage.
Huh.
That's just an action?
Yeah. I mean, it means I'm not attacking, but I'm not doing a whole lot of damage when I attack anyway. So if I just stand in front and block everything, no one gets past me.
Sure.
High AC, disadvantage on every attack.
Mm.
I'll do that. Starting next round.
She's gonna be literally a human shield.
Yep. And it's up to you with your laser beams to kill them.
No pressure.
No pressure at
all. No pressure. 15 is not
accurate. Right.
So,
if we're missing me most of the time now.
So you take 5 from the.
Okay.
Zombie. And then for another. Uh oh, I'm starting to hit. You're gonna get hit twice. Two ones. So you'll take 8 from the mouse.
8 altogether.
8 from the mouse, 2 attacks, and then whatever I said for the other one.
Okay. Yeah, definitely that one.
Okay, and then finally you're gonna get hit twice, 2. And a berry for 9 damage.
Okay.
Yeah, I think it's probably worth staying there as long as possible.
Yeah.
It's just extra hits you can take.
Yeah.
Alright, it is your turn. Fine.
Yeah, that's the only healing I can do right now, healing myself. And sucking up more damage. And 8 is a miss. Right?
Yep.
And then whatever that is going on,
yeah.
So hit for 12 damage.
Okay.
I'm blocking it.
Are you okay with my tactics?
Black's looking pretty good.
Which one?
My blocking them.
Sorry, it's your turn.
Okay.
I suppose so. I could take up more turn. I think I'm going to, I can do more here.
Alright, 23 and a 13.
Against.
Same dude.
Green. Okay.
Yeah.
and 7 damage and 5, so 12 total.
Okay.
Yes. Hard. Forgot that part.
Okay.
I can't move anymore.
I've only got 7 hit points, so.
Just let me soak up more damage. I am going to use my bonus on my turn to regain more.
Okay, but I'm in front. And I'm going to
attack and move back.
I can't because then he'll attack me. So I'm going to take the dodge action. It cuts the odds of hitting me way down.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I'll just live. Stand here and defend while you do attack.
Okay.
Kind of what I'm built for. But if they hit me, I'm dead.
So, 17?
It's 20.
It's 20, okay.
Mm-hmm.
So, that's a mess as well.
What does the defend
have? Disadvantage
on all
attacks. Yep, yeah, they missed all 4 attacks with disadvantage.
That is awesome.
So that's pretty sweet.
See them charging.
Shield.
Does a 13 hit you?
It does, yeah.
Okay, so you take 2 more hits.
Yeah.
8.
He stands there like a crossing guard. He's like, nope, denied. Your rewind's return.
Alright.
Okay, and it's now your turn.
Kill him.
I'm trying.
He's looking weak.
Oh, does a 12 hit?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, does.
It's 11 to hit that.
6 damage.
Okay.
Yes.
That one's definitely a miss. So.
Okay.
He drops.
Alright, fair.
Gain any more?
You got something else?
I'm just thinking if I should gain more hit points.
Mm.
Just using up spell slots and use all my first level and a third level.
Mm. So your AC is 20, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that because of the dodge?
No, that's okay. Base AC is 20.
Okay. What do you think? I only have 3 second level and 1 third level, so left.
Do you have any non-healing stuff that you could do with it?
Yeah, I mean, I have attacks, essentially. You can do, yeah, like attacks like Moonbeam.
Moonbeam is a good spell, if you're ever in human form to use it.
Yeah. Does it use my action each turn to?
I think it's a bonus action.
Bonus action, a lot of those spells are bonus action.
It's an action to move the beam 60 feet.
Okay, so an action to move it, but otherwise it's constantly damaged if whoever's in it.
Yeah. I could save those up for that. The only third level spell I have is Wind Wall, though, so.
That's not useful.
Yeah, not very. Blocks, like, ranged attacks, but these guys aren't doing that. So, I'm going to burn my other third level slot to regain 3d8 hit points.
Hmm.
And hopefully it won't be a 9 again this time. 7 plus 2 is 9 plus 2 is 11. Alright, well, slightly below average, but I'll be back down to 17 damage. Okay, I'm done.
Okay, Curious.
Alright. Blasting green. 18 and 11.
So they both
hit? No, the green is Malibu, so he's a 12.
He's a 12? Can I change that beam off somebody else?
No.
I declare that I was wrong. Fine, only one hit, and it is 11 points of damage.
Right.
And I blow him 10 feet.
Not that it matters.
No.
I do a bonus action to heal more on myself, and then I dodge.
Okay.
Probably take 2 hits to knock me down now.
Okay. That was almost there. 19.
Mm-hmm.
In the second. Yep.
This is so freaking. I've got this covered.
This is so freaking. Ryan will take 3. And they're done, now back to LG.
The one lucky round for them, that gun.
Yeah. I'm going to crumble like a house of cards.
Oh, you see?
I don't have any hit points. I have 13 hit points. You beat me down pretty quick.
12 on that guy.
The black guy, he goes down. Oh, to hit?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But then it's 4, 8, 19, 11 damage.
Yes.
Okay. And then...
there's a bright spot at the end of the solar system.
Then I'll scoot up.
Yep.
And 10 to hit that guy.
It's 10 now. 12.
Yeah.
Okay, Farius. Green.
Yes, one more time. Alright, 16 and 21. He's taking both hits.
Yep.
He is taking 7 and then 5.
That is
12.
Exactly enough to blow him back against the
Now you turn to the other one and go, do you want to run now?
You still think you don't need reinforcements?
You hear a slithering sound.
Oh, not another one.
Not necessarily a big one. There are a few others, but pencil tails.
Wait, behind us?
Mm-hmm.
Ah, I drink a potion.
let's see, that was Farius' turn. It is Velen's.
You want to move, though?
I do want to move. I don't know where.
It's about as good as it gets. Velen, your turn.
I boldly stride forward.
Okay.
Actually, we should get, see if we can get to that funky one. But then there's not much point in defending, because he'll just attack.
I can get it down, so.
He goes right after me, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'll go ahead and move and dodge, yeah. So if he tries to move to attack, he'll wait to attack. If he doesn't, then I'm dodging.
Okay. Get flanking with him. So, go in my 5, 6, so 10 damage plus 11 damage. 21
damage?
Yeah.
It's all he's taken so far.
Okay.
Yeah. 21?
Mm-hmm.
Farius.
You have to move so you can see him.
Yeah. So, what is it diagonally? That's 2, that's 15.
Well, 3 of my friends.
So, 1, 2, 3,
4 squares.
Well, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can go here, 4.
That's 20.
And then go 25, 30.
I'll go there.
Okay.
Because I can still see him and I'm farther away from the door.
Mm-hmm.
So
there's no door, it's just a hole.
Oh, well, whatever. The opening that I don't want to be next to. How's that?
Yeah.
Just don't push me into the corner.
Alright, first one's a miss, second one's going to be 23.
Mm-hmm.
So that one's going to hit him for a whopping 3 damage.
Mm-hmm.
It always starts out soft. I don't understand.
No.
Alright. Now that the bears here are maybe I should risk attacking.
Mason!
With the advantage, I mean, I've still got the 20 AC, so.
Yeah.
There's a decent chance he won't hit me.
Yeah.
Mason!
So, yeah, I pull out my mace.
Okay.
Spray some right in the knees.
It's a hit?
Yes.
Okay, when you hit him, there's a crack and a bright flash, and arcs of, like, electrical energy surge through your target's body.
Nice.
Okay, well, I do 4 damage plus that.
Plus, okay.
I need to re-identify this, I guess.
Yeah. Okay. He goes. He's like.
You have the mace.
He tried to attack you twice, and he's shaking so bad he misses both of us. Elder.
The old freaking bonus.
Your roll to hit on that was what?
Now they've got this.
It was a 20 total?
Okay, yeah.
5 damage, and then 11 damage.
11 damage.
11 plus 5, 16 total.
16, all right, that brings you down.
All right.
He's gone.
Yes.
And start running?
Yes. There's an abomination slithering down the hallway.
That way.
5, 10, 15, 25, 30, 35. I shouldn't block the door, should I?
That was your one move ahead. Yeah, you kind of went extra.
Oh, did I? I'll just go here instead.
So, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25.
That's it?
Yeah, I said you counted one extra one.
25. So you should have another 15 feet. But won't I block the hallway if I go down there?
No.
I'll just stay in the rear. Do this. Nothing to matter.
Okay. You want to blast him in one or just.
Various is totally.
Blast him.
This is open?
Yeah, this is all. The hallway continues here and then it turns. Which way? I can't see. It turns this way, I think, back here.
So I can move 30 until the last time, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So we go 5, 10, 15, 5, 10.
Yeah.
No, I'm not going diagonal.
You want to go diagonal.
I don't want to go diagonal.
Because it will get you there faster.
So that's 10?
That's 10, yep. Then all you have to do is remember that since you've moved diagonally once, you're fine unless you move diagonally again, then it will be an extra 5 feet.
Oh.
So it's for diagonal spaces, you add an extra 5 feet of it.
So the first diagonal is 5?
First diagonal is 5.
But second. The second one is going to be 15.
Then as long as you move in a straight line, then the second one's going to be an extra 5 feet. So it'll be 10 feet instead of 5.
Okay, so I'm at what right now?
15?
So I can actually go here and still see the hall?
I would just attack him first.
Yeah, you attack first.
Just stay where you are.
Okay.
Blast him and then move after you're done.
Okay, fine. I blast him.
Blast him and move. Blast him and move. 19 and 18, so we're looking at a whatever. It's more than I need to be. Because it's a 24 and a 23.
Yep.
And it's going to take 7 and then 4.
Okay.
So.
Alright, so you basically just want to start running down the hallway?
Yes.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Okay. Here
goes. I don't need to tell you.
Did you knock him 10 feet back?
20.
20.
Good God, he can move.
Oh, didn't quite re-kill him.
Okay, that'll do.
Can he reach you from there? Would he get an attack if I ran?
He can reach you with his constrict from there.
Does he have the opportunity?
He doesn't threaten, I don't think. He doesn't, like, normally have... Does it say anywhere if they have reach? I mean, his attack has that range, but I don't think he threatens it.
I think you do... Technically.
Really? It says reach 10 feet.
Yeah, so he's got 10 foot.
Okay, so he threatens over there.
So we're already engaged, at least I am.
Yeah.
Should I stand him? Can we stand and fight him? Can we handle that?
I've done 11 damage to him. Is he as big as the other one that we fought?
What did that guy take?
Over 100, like 120. And we've done 11 to him.
Well, save 10% of the way there.
Do you want to fireball him?
No, that's not the type of spell you want to waste on one dude.
This dude we do.
Here's a thought. If you two want to keep running, free the animals. I will stand here, defend, possibly die, but hopefully not. And when things get really sticky, I just melt into stone.
Yeah. Even if you die?
No, if I die, then I'm dead. But
he's saying hopefully he can roll the dice enough where he can melt into stone before he dies. But what if he constricts you? Does that stop you from melding in the stone?
No.
What if you meld in the stone and make yourself into a door?
I just disappear into the stone
wall. Oh, okay. That's not going to work. Like I said, he can make himself a stone door and he can't get out. That would be awesome. I shut thing and I run away.
I cannot outrun him, period. I don't think anything. So, we have to stand and fight, don't we?
If he runs, I can, and someone can ride on my back. Because I run 40 feet. My speed is 40 feet. It's the same as his.
Okay, but then we're just going to run and he'll stay on our tail.
Yeah. Pretty much. So,
unless we get somewhere where we can.
If I double move, I'm 60 feet.
But his double move is 80 feet, so he'd catch up to you.
Yeah, I fought.
I could.
I turn. I got mage hand into the wall.
You want mage hand? I got it. You want me to spider climb?
What do you want? What do you want? Come on, pick a card. Just pick a card.
I could also go wolf shape, which is 50 feet, so that's faster than him.
I can just do witch ball.
One of us.
Right. Well, and then someone can ride on my back, but then there's still one.
I could do witch bolt, and he grabs onto me as he
can. You carry both of us? Can you carry both of us as a bear? What's your strength?
19.
15 times 19 is.
What if you meld in the stone right now, and I jump on his back and run, and he chases after us?
Strength is a dire wolf is still 17, and that's speed 50.
What do you think? What if you meld in the stone right now, because he wouldn't be able to reach him, and you come running by me, and I jump on your back and run?
Mm-hmm.
We're already ahead of him. He's got to chase after.
I think since you're a quadruped, you can actually carry both of us with that strength score.
Hmm. The 19 or the 17?
The 19.
Mm.
So, we could both hop on his back. He runs away. You blast him with Holger Blast as we run. So
push him back.
You push him back. We slowly gain me.
Until I miss and he eats us all.
Well, no. He doesn't gain on us at all. We keep even with him, but your blasts push him back.
Yeah, but every blast pushes him back. Yeah, that's true.
I think that's our best chance.
So you have to hit him twice. You have to hit him.
No. We stay even with him.
Even if every turn that he misses completely, we stay at the same pace.
But you are. Okay, so that Eldritch Blast is an attack roll.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so you're going to be mounted and.
Riding a bear.
Making an attack roll, which means you're going to take negatives to your attack roll.
I'm gonna try it if you guys are. I got a plus five in my spell bonus.
The downside I see is we're running blind down the hall.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't know what's happening.
Well, not exactly where we're going.
So is this a risk worth taking, or do we stand and fight?
Well, unless we have a spell that we're gonna kill him with in a couple of turns. Because he's gonna. He'll drop me one hit. I guarantee it.
You're both low in hit points.
I got 13.
Yeah, I don't think
14.
I don't think we can afford it. I mean, I have a good number. I can just keep healing myself as a bonus action, but it's only second level spell slots.
And I've got only minor heals.
So I could, I could stand at the front and just try and take the brunt of the damage. And maybe even, just defend. But,
in the front, then I'll be attacking from a distance.
Yeah. Which is not your strong suit, right?
Not really. I'm really not very offensive in general.
Yeah. I don't get offended by it much.
I think we should run.
Let's do that. It helps.
Can we tell? Can I make a perception check on this guy?
Let's
want to see if he's got his armband on.
Okay. Yes. Okay. So you can tell that without making a perception check.
Okay. Then we run back to where the animals are, and we jump through the barrier.
That's where you're going right now, is where the animals are.
That's what I'm saying. If we go through the barrier, he can't cross.
You're going around the back way.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. No, he's got to take his armband off.
He can cross. If you're wearing the band, you can get out.
Mm-hmm.
So if we go in the back and then go up front, then...
Yeah, we could circle around them.
But if we beat him to the door, can't we lock him out? Or is it lock from the outside?
Locks from the outside.
From the outside. So we can lock you in. But you can still go through the door.
Yep. Either way, can't we just loop around and then come back?
Do you think he'd be scared enough of those animals that he wouldn't follow us in there? Possibly.
Maybe. But if they stay locked up, then he might not have a reason to.
Unless I put my hand across the lock and bluff him. I'm good.
Okay, that is a chance.
Yeah.
It's at least something other than running wildly through the hallways. Okay, I'm going to take the disengage action. Move over here. I can't mount, because that would use too much movement. Can you...
Wait, you down the hole.
How much movement does it take?
Half your movement.
Disengage, you only get one movement. You don't get.
I think so. It is your action to disengage.
Yeah, it uses your action.
You don't get a movement in addition to that?
Other than your normal movement now. It's like you get a move and an action each turn, and
right.
You use your action to disengage and use the normal.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah, so that you don't take the attack.
Gotcha.
That's all you're doing.
Yeah.
And I'm guessing 4 is just over half your move.
4 is my full of it.
Oh, okay.
You had stayed over here, then go 1, 2.
Oh, man.
Oh. I am going to hold the rear line for one round. You'll run. I'll mount you next round. But he'll get an attack on me, I guess.
Okay.
So use.
Aren't you worried that'll drop you?
Yeah.
Why don't you get beside him, because that way if it does drop you, he can still grab you. He doesn't have to come back for you.
Or do you have enough hit points to withstand him for 2 full attacks?
For 2 full attacks? I have 14 currently left in bear form, and I have 3 second level spell slots. That once it gets back to my turn, I could maybe get more, but...
I'm not ready.
Yeah.
This is all split-second decision-making.
Yeah,
exactly.
But there's a reason we're sitting at a table and not actually running down a hallway being chased by a giant snake monster.
Because I'm
Okay, here's... He goes right after you, right? Right after Amy?
It's Farius, then him, then Galvin,
okay.
Then Elvin.
So, I will disengage, go back here, and dodge. I can't disengage and dodge. I will go here, dodge, and cast Shield of Faith on myself, so my AC will be 22. You delay until after he goes, and then push him back 10 feet so that I don't have to disengage. And then I will run over a mount, and then we all run.
Well, let's go for
strategy,
it.
Strategy, sure. Why not?
Okay. So
I'm just holding action until after his turn.
Yeah.
Correct.
Okay. Do you need me to... No, I can't move.
Or you can even do it. No, just delay. It's better that way.
I'm just going to delay, because if I move, you won't be able to...
The only problem is if he beats my 22 AC, he's likely to stop me. And that's not that hard.
thinking.
I don't think so either. I mean, if he's got disadvantage on every tackle, it's pretty hard. Even with a high attack bonus on disadvantage.
So we're going to do that. Shield of Faith. And
cross everything, guys.
Shield of Faith and dodge, and then Elduin and Farius will both hold their actions.
Yeah, I think they'll just delay until after he goes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Correct.
Alright, so then Elduin and Farius, then him. So he will move up here. He will attempt first to strike you with his scimitar. That'll miss. And he will attempt to constrict you. That will miss. And then he will attempt to bite you. That will miss.
Okay, you push him away. I'd say mount him first, so that you got a straight line to shoot him down the hall.
It's your turn first.
He is delayed. They just delayed.
Right.
So they're changing order. Okay. So they now go after him.
All right, so Farius first.
Yeah. So if you mount him, shoot him straight down the hall, hit him at least once.
That's going to be you may move the bear.
Yeah.
Mount and fire.
Yes.
And then who will be after Farius?
He's not going to stay there. You're going to have to wait for me again, I guess.
Yeah.
So is there anything you can do with that turn?
Yeah, I can regain hit points.
Most of it.
Okay.
So that's what you do. Yeah. So I'll go ahead and do that now.
Okay, so it's going to be Farius, then Elden, then Gelden.
Actually, you could have regained hit points on your actual turn before.
That's true. I mean, yeah.
So instead of delaying.
I'll say that when I do this upcoming turn.
So do you want me to blast him down the hall now?
Yes.
Nice. 6 plus 7. 13.
But then you need to go after me. Right after me.
Okay.
So Farius, then Belden, then Elden.
Yes.